Hello, and welcome back to Storytime with Papa Senpi. This time we're reading the story of Cafe Memoria. And this one as you can see, it's quite something. But anyway, sit back and relax and enjoy the story. Wait, this has got voice acting. Ah, the morning. It's a beautiful morning. Albeit a little chilly. As usual, I get out of bed, brush my teeth, and I get dressed. I go downstairs and find there is nothing to eat for breakfast. Shoot, I totally forgot to go to grocery shopping yesterday. I guess I was too tired from all those classes. At least I have the day off. I heard about this new cafe that's recently opened in town. It's called Cafe Memoria. Perhaps I wish to stop by there and have my breakfast. Also, I heard that a friend of mine from school works there. I wonder who. I know Julia would most likely work there, given her talent for cooking. Especially the curry. The ones she cooks are among the best curries ever. I exit the house and enter the cafe. As I enter, I am greeted by Anna, one of my friends at school. A chubby box with girl. She is startled as she sees me.
Ryan? I didn't know you would come here.
Oh god. I feel a bit redundant now since it's got voice acting. No more for my glorious voice acting. That's a bit of a shame. Let's see how this goes.
I'm sorry I scared you, Anna. I didn't mean to. Maybe I should come another day?
This guy's a complete wimp. Oh, of course, everyone's a good point exactly. What am I supposed to do? Just sit here and click buttons?
No, it's okay.
Okay.
I mean, buttons, this
so
is totally your story.
You work
for,
here?
Oh god, let's talk over that. This is book story time. Yeah. Let's just go to you.
Yeah. In fact, my mother owns this cafe.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Since I can't really read this, I remain that vocal of my opponents of these stories. But I'm going to be very judgmental. Oh, finally something I can do. Her eyes always seem to be dark away, and she tends to fidget whenever we are having a conversation. She can be pretty sharp, indeed.
Mother says that working here will help me with my confidence. I don't think so. I really don't feel like working here. I'm just going to cause problems. Yeah.
With that attitude, you will.
Well, you got to at least try. You can't be shy forever, right?
I guess it was pretty much my choice to work here, though.
She suddenly starts to panic as she's forgotten something.
I'm so sorry. I'm not doing my job. I'm supposed to take you to your table. See? I already messed up.
No, that normally happens in this industry.
Don't worry about it.
Thanks. Let's go to your table.
Anna brings me to an empty table. I look around the restaurant looking at the brand new furnishings. It smells pretty fresh in here. Too, like a brand new car. You can tell a lot of time and effort was invested into building this restaurant.
Here's your menu!
As she hands the menu to me, she accidentally drops it on the floor. Being Anna, she starts to panic. There's no room for panic in this industry. I'm pretty damn good at talking about people's voices. Yeah, it's something that me and Boba always do, games. She picks up the menu. She's really fidgety, trembling as she's really scared, and backed into a corner. She hands it to me without dropping it.
Here.
Thanks, Anna.
You're welcome. So, what would you, like to drink?
You just handed me the menu. This has just been 5 seconds. A great drink for the part of calcium milk. sunrise, just through to the glass. Grapefruit, prune, Washington, or cashew. Is this America? Lemonade's not sour, it's sweet. Yeah, let's just go to the lemonade.
Okay, I'll be back.
Thanks, Anna.
What happens if I select a different
welcome,
one?
Ryan.
Ryan leaves and goes to get my drink. I look from afar as she just wanders around, struggling to find the beverage bar. She starts panicking and freaking out.
Why must this happen to me? I could have sworn that the drinks were over here. I can't keep Ryan waiting. He's going to think I'm a bad waitress. But I am a bad waitress after all.
If that's our attitude, you're going nowhere.
I'm so stupid. I can't believe they were over there.
She fills up a cup with the drink, then comes back with it. Although she takes her time walking back.
Here's your drink. I'm so sorry that I took so long.
No worries. Thanks. In fact, I think it was cute watching you trying to find the drinks.
You see me face falling right now, because that's what I am doing.
Huh? You were watching me?
Yeah.
Smooth, Ryan. Very smooth.
Ryan, don't watch me! It's so embarrassing.
Why not? It's pretty funny.
She gets angry and starts to pout. She then tries to say something, but she simply can't get her words out.
You're so mean, Ryan!
How predictable.
Sorry. Well, to put it in a way, I'm just looking after you, as your friend. Sometimes you worry me.
Oh.
She starts blushing really hard.
Thanks. Sorry if I got mad at you.
Don't worry about it. You didn't do anything wrong.
Oh, okay. He really cares about me.
Huh?
It's nothing.
All of a sudden, that seems to remember something and lets out an outburst of emotions.
Oh no, I forgot to ask you. Are you ready with your order yet?
Whoa, calm down. You almost scared me.
I'm so sorry, Ryan. It just came into my head all of a sudden. Oh, I think I'm going crazy.
She collapses to the floor in a panic. I help her to her feet and I help her calm down. Lucky for her, it's just me and the rest and a few employees. I happen to overhear some of them talk about Anna collapsing with a concerned tone in their voices. Apparently, other employees know about her timid nature. Maybe it has happened before.
I'm so sorry, Ryan.
It's okay. I've got your back.
Thank you. Anyway, what would you like to order?
Because why would you go out to just eat a bowl of cereal? Pancakes. No, you can just... You can make all of these at home. We're gonna have a meal for a man.
Okay. Waffles, sausage links, and eggs it is.
I really wish the restaurant would come up with a better name for that food item.
Well, I couldn't come up with something better. So I figured that would be a suitable name.
You designed the menu?
Don't make fun of me, okay? I'm just not that creative. That's all.
Who gave her the job to design the menu? She looks at me, her eyes begging me not to judge her. Why would I? I never judge her. Nor do I have a reason to.
It's okay. No worries.
I'm glad. Okay, I'll be back with your, food.
As Anna leaves, I go on and watch her. She struggles to give the ticket to the chefs at the back of the restaurant. She just stands there, not saying anything. Eventually, she gives them the ticket. She goes to the front of the restaurant, greeting the other guests that arrive. She talks to them with a nervous stutter in her voice, just as she were talking to me. Regardless, she always stutters when talking to people. I hope that one day, Anna won't be too nervous and timid. Although, I have to admit, her personality is kind of cute. Eventually, the cooks call Anna over, and she brings me my food.
Here's your food! I hope you enjoy it.
Thanks, Anna. You're doing a pretty good job so far.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh. I think I'll be taking my break.
Not subtle at all.
Okay, enjoy your break.
Thanks.
Anna leaves the area, leaving me to enjoy my food. I hear a mumble as she walks away.
Ryan complimented me. I'm so happy. Maybe I can do this job, after all.
I'll try the sausage links first. They are pretty hot, no kidding. So I kept it to avoid burning myself. Wow, some of the fat gives us a juicy, meaty flavor. I take a few more bites of the sausage, then move on to the scrambled eggs. This is nice, warm and fluffy. Why am I reading an entire scenario of eating food? Anyone here knows, just continue. Which reminds me, sometimes people cook their scrambled eggs halfway. You don't cook scrambled eggs halfway. You cook scrambled eggs till they're done. America is sure a strange place, giving the eggs a yolky texture, which I don't like. After finishing my eggs, I proceed to the waffles. They are pretty good too, with a complimentary butter and blueberries. The meal is very protein rich. Sure to fulfill your appetite. It's no surprise that this breakfast classic has been around for a long time during its popularity. Anna comes back to check on me.
Hey, Ryan.
What's up, Anna?
I hope you like the food.
It's pretty good.
I'm glad.
Yeah, I'm really digging these blueberries on the waffles.
Digging? Really?
We also put strawberries. Pineapples on them, too.
Why you put pineapples on waffles?
Coconut.
That's new. Who would have heard about putting pineapples and coconut on pancakes? Maybe I'll try that next time. Or maybe Anne's just saying stuff out of her shyness. After a while, I finish my food. Anna hands me the food bill. I pay for it and receive my change.
I'm glad you stopped over at my mother's restaurant.
Well, I'm happy you're working at the restaurant. Maybe you'll see yourself improving.
Perhaps. Yeah. Thanks, Ryan.
No problem. I don't want you feeling down all the time.
Ryan?
Yeah?
One more thing. I'd like you to rate me on this form. Maybe I can improve with your suggestions. Who's gonna rate me good?
And why does everyone notice this? When someone thinks in their head, why does it echo sometimes? Before it doesn't echo, unless you don't have a brain in there, and then... Yeah, it probably does echo then.
Sure.
She hands me a feedback slip, filled with various items. Let's see. When I'm considering this, if this was my... Personally, I would rate it pretty harshly. But hey, this is a video game, you have a friend, let's just give it a very friendly. Speed of cell, frickin' slow as hell. We'll give it an 8. Food quality was actually pretty good. Yes, she claps on the floor. That's very exceptional. But sure, even there's butt-letting nothing on the menu. Do you like the waitress overall? It's an odd question. Oh, sure, yeah. There we go, done.
So I did a superior job. I'm so happy.
That's not the word I would have described it, but whatever.
I knew you did your best, Anna.
Well, I didn't think I would do that good of a job.
But you didn't.
It shows that you were trying. That's what matters. I'm proud of you.
Thank you. Yes. I'll still try my best.
Though she's frail and a modest girl, her tone of her voice sounds very sincere. It makes me happy. At times at school, she seems unmotivated because of the fear of being judged. But with the right words, she can get going. I hope she can maintain it. She can quickly lose confidence if something goes wrong. But this time, I doubt it. After writing Anna, I took my leave to run some errands, and I thought that Anna and her mother run that cafe. I knew that Anna would take over the place one day. She made it look like a timid girl she is now. But people do indeed grow. I approach the exit. Anna stops me and leaves me with some parting words.
Thanks for coming, Ryan. I hope you will return soon.
Thanks, Anna. Good luck to you.
See you in school on Monday.
You too.
Perhaps I'll return this year again. Best of luck to Anna. She's lucky that her mother's letting her work there. End of Anna's route.
Cafe Memoria?
Dear God, this is intro to skin cancer. Bam, degree cancer. What's in the next piece? So we get tiny picture and concept drawing. Yeah, it just goes straight to a heels. Now on earth do we unlock Ryan? Do we have to unlock everybody else's Ryan's? And the second one we collect is a speedy one.
Cafe Memoria.
Very frankly, I would say that's enough for today. Hope you enjoyed this story. If you have any recommendations, just comment down below. And if you want me to continue this story, just say so. And also, if you recommend any other stories, vision novels, books, whatever really, I can happily to read it. Have a good evening, and see ya.